I first became involved with the Hmong Voices project through my role in initiating and sponsoring Assembly Bill 78 in 2003, which is the legislation that asks for social science and history instruction in grades 7 to 12 to include the Southeast Asians' role in contributions to the Vietnam War. I believe it is crucial to take something that has been said to make it become a reality. I saw AB 78 as an opportunity for Fresno Unified School District to take a lead in developing a Hmong Voices curriculum, and I approached my supervisor, Pat Rowe, who has always been very open to innovative ideas such as this.
I really thought it was just a fabulous opportunity to merge learning with history, with real life experiences that could really touch lives and be something that we could not only have these videos to use in classrooms, but students could be taught how to recapture their own stories on video for their own families. And I thought, what better way for Fresno Unified to participate in this project than to do this?
I had the chance to work on the very first round of Hmong Voices back in 2004. I was the coordinator for the program and had the chance to work with the first six or seven young people who produced Hmong Voices.
To me, it's important for these students to have an adult mentor with them so that they can find a connection with someone, so that they can learn from that person. And I think it's what makes Hmong Voices and some of the other projects so successful, is that it's the storyteller, the mentor, and the student working together. And that is an important part of Hmong Voices.
They're definitely powerful stories that need to be told out there. You just see it from a different point of view, and makes you realize what those people went through.
The real impact was that the students who were involved in these projects had emotional revelations about their parents, about their parents' experiences, and stories that had never been told, that were in fact kind of held as secret, probably because of the pain that was involved in these stories, came out often for the first time. And so relationships between second generation Hmongs and their parents were transformed forever.
I really feel that in some small way, you know, these kids who worked on Hmong Voices had a big part in demystifying the whole secret war in Laos and opening it up as a way for people to communicate that story and make sure that that message is heard.